Syrian government troops have launched a major offensive to root out rebel fighters in the suburbs of Damascus. But many school children inside the capital are trying to go about their normal daily lives amid the bullets and the bombs. We have a report from Alex Thompson of Independent Television News.
Yes, they yell, "We're ready for lessons," and in they come. And it's 1,600 pupils at this Damascus school, two shifts across the day. Under the ever watchful eye of President Assad, reading lessons for children in a city, a country at war with itself. What kind of things are these little girls seeing beyond the school gates?
We as educators don't support one side or the other. Our concern is for the child to learn. So we keep the school open and help with their fears. We can't do as much as before, but the key thing is to try and deal with their anxiety.
Up, down, left, right, two, three, four. Out in the playground, it's a PE lesson. Exercises including running to the wall, touching it and running back. Here, the running's for fun. But beyond the school walls, a shell or a mortar can land anywhere, anytime. Running can be a matter of life and death. For obvious reasons, the killing of small children and teachers in and around school buildings is pretty near the top of the news agenda at the moment. So it is that in this educational district and the one next door alone, in the past 2 weeks, 35 small children and two teachers have been killed. The security building next to the school was car bombed recently, leaving a staff candid about the problems they face here.
Lots of children had to leave their areas, friends, teachers, and move, which is very difficult. Also, we get students pushed out from places, so the school's new to them. We do our best to help, but it's beyond us. It's way too big.
And then little Zebra Asadi said she wanted to sing us a patriotic song. But she was soon overwhelmed by the general chant, "God, Syria, Bashar al-Assad." Asked to draw a picture, this little lad has come up with tanks, guns, in the colours of the government flag. This is one of several shelters across Damascus for people displaced by the fighting.
The reason we're doing this is because we've seen what happens to Syrians who have to leave the country for refugee camps. They're treated very badly. We don't want that to happen again.
They may wear anoraks, which are in fact the flag of Assad Syria, but they claim anyone here is welcome, whatever their political affiliation. Perhaps predictably, we couldn't find anyone here who said they supported the rebels. Nihaya Muha said any opportunity to go home would be lethal.
They threaten me if I go back because I did not go to protest there, because I support the president.
In a place where Assad's senior and junior stare down, how open can you be? As families eat, one man still wouldn't speak openly, even in denouncing the rebels in a place like this.
Sometimes I have to go home to pick up stuff. The rebels are not in the house, but they have surrounded the area. If they see me criticizing them, they will liquidate me.
And yet, just a mile or two away, Damascus, old city. Mosques, neighbour churches. Inside the famed Haretna restaurant, Sunnis dine alongside a christening party and a nun. The world of hair straighteners blends with the world of hijabs. It is a cocoon in a city, a country where religion and politics are tearing things apart.